Let's talk about eligibility. Not everyone is eligible to apply for a GRFP fellowship. You have to be a U.S. citizen, national or permanent resident. You should also be early in your training, either an undergraduate student or a graduate student. You should wish to pursue a research-based graduate degree, a master's degree or a doctoral degree, in any kind of STEM field. We will talk about the different fields a little bit later. But most importantly, if you apply, you should be ready to enroll in an accredited U.S. institution by the fall after you apply for the fellowship. As a GRFP applicant, you are allowed to apply at different times in your career. What does that mean? You can apply as an undergraduate senior or as someone who has received an undergraduate degree, but who has not started graduate school yet. You can apply as a first-year graduate student, typically a month or two after you've started graduate school. If you have not applied as a first-year graduate student, then you can apply in your second year. This level of applicant has less than 12 months of graduate study by August 1st of the application year. Finally, you can apply if you had more than 12 months of graduate studies under your belt and an interruption of more than 2 years in your graduate training. Those are students who wish to come back to graduate school. How often can you apply for the graduate research fellowship? It's not unusual to apply more than once. However, you're limited to one application per yearly competition. As a senior or someone with an undergraduate degree, you can apply as often as you wish before starting graduate school. However, you must be prepared to be enrolled in graduate school the fall after you win the fellowship. After you're enrolled in graduate school, there is a restriction. You can apply only once as a graduate student, either in your first year or in the second year of your graduate training. The eligible fields of study in the Graduate Research Fellowship Program are listed here, ranging from chemistry to STEM education. During the application process, you have to indicate which field of study best matches the research you will do in the training you will receive in graduate school. Your selection of a field of study is used to assign your application to a review panel of professionals who will evaluate your application. This is a very critical selection, so keep that in mind. Consult with your advisor and mentors if it's unclear which panel you should apply to. The panels are listed on the NSF GRFP website. On the topic of eligibility, we have to point out areas and degree programs that are not supported. Individuals enrolled in a joint science professional degree program, for example, an MD-PhD or JD-PhD program, would not be eligible to receive support through GRFP. Also, any kind of business administration or management programs are not supported. Counseling, social work, education, history, except STEM education and STEM history, would not be supported. If you plan to conduct research with directly disease-related goals, you would not be eligible for the support through GRFP. Clinical research, patient-oriented research, and health services or policy research are also not supported. Let's talk about the GRFP application timeline. The solicitation is typically posted in July-August. Make sure that you understand when your specific application deadline is. It's typically at the end of October. Your reference letter writers will need to submit their letters very early in November. Between November and the end of March, NSF determines the recipients of the GRFP awards and honorable mention with input from the panels of expert reviewers. If you are offered an award, you have to accept it before May 1st, at which time you also have to declare your fellowship status. Your fellowship year begins either on June 1st or September 1st of the year after you applied.